Hi, I can smell a lot of hype in the air. Welcome to the 13th episode of Animal Battle. This episode is going to be a special one, because these two competitors have hundreds of millions of die-hard fans, but only one can be the ultimate winner. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce you to our two competitors. The dog versus the cat. And stay tuned until the end of the video to find out the winner of the last battle between the gorilla and the orangutan. Let's do it. I'm Aro, and this is Animal Battle. So how exactly will we find out who is better? Well, in each episode of Animal Battle, we evaluate the two competitors based on six different characteristics: agility, attack, defense, intelligence, bonus skill, and survival. But in this episode, we will need to add another secret characteristic, which is actually extremely important for cats and dogs. And don't worry, I'm not going to be biased, because I love both dogs and cats the same, and in each episode of Animal Battle, I try being as objective as possible. So let's head right to agility stats. So dog breeds vary a lot, but on average, they can run with a speed of 24 to 32 km per hour. The fastest dog breeds like greyhounds, though, can reach incredible speeds of up to 72 km per hour. And then there are some breeds like the Siberian Husky that can run at a constant speed of 16 to 24 km per hour for very long distances. What about cats? The fastest cats can reach speeds of up to 48 km per hour, and the average cat is faster than the average dog. Also, cats have other abilities like being good climbers and jumping to a height 6 times bigger than their body length. Also, it is true that cats almost always land on their feet. Being very flexible, the cat rotates its front and back ends in different directions to push against itself in mid-air. This way it quickly turns and then lands on its four legs to absorb the shock. Also, they can survive very high falls. One cat has fallen from the 32nd floor and survived with only a couple of broken ribs. No wonder why people say that cats have 9 lives. Now let's see their agility stats. So both have high agility stats, but cats are overall more agile than dogs. Now let's go to their attack and defense stats. So dogs vary a lot in size. The smallest dog was a Yorkshire Terrier, which measured only 9.5 centimeters and weighed 113 grams. But the largest dog was an English Mastiff, weighing 155 kilograms and measuring 250 centimeters in length. Cats are usually way smaller, reaching around 46 cm in length plus a 30 cm long tail, and can weigh around 4 to 5 kg. The largest cat ever recorded weighed 21 kg. Cats usually hunt small prey like birds and rodents, but they are so good at this that yearly, cats hunt up to 24 billion animals only in USA. For hunting, they use the ambush technique, and when they are near the prey, they attack. Dogs though are stronger on average, being quite bigger. Some dogs, like Kangals, have a bite force of up to 743 psi, which is stronger than the bite force of a lion. Also, dogs use barking for intimidation. Cats can also intimidate, trying to appear bigger, but it is not as effective. Both cats and dogs can be hunted by larger predators in the wild, but because they usually live around humans, they are safer. So let's see their stats. Well, cats aren't that good here due to their small size. While dogs are considerably better at attack and defense than cats, they are still not as impressive as other large carnivores. That was weird. Let's move on to bonus skills now. So cats and dogs have a couple of senses more developed than in humans. Cats can smell 14 times better than humans, but that is nothing compared to the sense of smell of dogs, which is actually 1000 times better than that of humans. Also, dogs can hear 4 times as far as humans, but cats are even better at this, being able to hear higher pitched sounds. Cats have an excellent night vision and can see at only 1/6 the level of light required for human vision. This is because the light is reflected back into the eye by a special layer, and that is why cats' eyes might shine in the dark. Dogs also have better night vision than humans, but during the day it is worse. And we shouldn't forget about cats' ability to purr. It is believed that purring promotes the regeneration of tissues, and cats purr to heal themselves. So their bonus skills are quite good. It's time to go to their intelligence stats. Cats are quite smart because they are carnivores, and hunting requires a higher level of intelligence. But a study has shown that dogs have twice as many neurons as cats, which means that dogs should be a little bit smarter. Dogs can usually understand human body language and have a good memory. So let's see their intelligence stats. They're pretty good, dogs being a little bit better here. And before we go to the secret stats, we will quickly talk about survival, and they're doing very well here. There are more than 500 million cats and around 900 million dogs in the world. Cats usually live around 15 years, and dogs live 10 to 13 years on average. The oldest dog died at the age of 29.5 years, and the oldest cat died at the age of 38 years. So their survival stats are quite high. Still, dogs and cats don't have very outstanding stats. But there is one thing that changes everything and makes dogs and cats some of the best animals in the world. That thing is our secret characteristic, and it is their bonds with humans. Dogs and cats are the most known animals, and living around humans has given them a lot of advantages, like free food and shelter. A very important ability for bonding with humans is the good boy ability, available to both dogs and cats. It gives a huge moral boost and counters depression and loneliness. They become some of the best friends for humans, and dogs are quite useful. Dogs can be used in herding livestock, for hunting, for searching and rescuing humans, as guard dogs or for detecting drugs. Also, there are guide dogs that help blind people, and some dogs are used for psychiatric services. They have so many utilities that there is no wonder why humans love them so much. But what about cats? They can't be used in so many fields like dogs. So what makes them so beloved? Well, while dogs help humans, cats actually are helped by an organism called toxoplasmosis. In the wild, it is actually transmitted to mice, and it infects their nervous system, and it makes mice fear cats less to be easily caught. And it might work the same for humans, making them less afraid and more attracted to cats. It is estimated that half of all humans are infected by toxoplasmosis. The price for the drugs used to counter toxoplasmosis has recently increased by 5,000%. So cats and dogs became very close to humans in different ways. Dogs being useful in a lot of fields, and cats infecting us with a bacteria. And this allowed both of them to thrive alongside humans. But it might come at a cost. Humans created breeds over time, and it had a negative impact on the health and the look of some dogs and cats. Now let's see their final stats. So they have pretty interesting stats, but we still need to answer the most important question. Who is the winner? Well, it is up to you, because you are the ones that can vote in the poll right there, and leave your precious opinions in the comments down below. And also tell your friends, if you have any, parents, and most importantly, tell your babushka to smash that subscribe button, because I won't rest until we beat both PewDiePie and T-Series. Great, it is time to announce the winner of the last battle between the gorilla and the orangutan. So, after counting all the votes, the winner is the gorilla! A powerful and intelligent animal, which is a great candidate for the title, the best animal in the world. And those who voted for the orangutan, don't be upset, because here, on I'm From Animals, we know that all animals are amazing. So, once again, don't forget to vote the winner of this episode's battle in the top right corner, and if you like what I make, consider supporting me on Patreon. Respect animals.